Dan Spatariu, who is a yoga practitioner, and his experiences from the association that he has founded and the way that authority has dealt with this association.
Thank you. Good afternoon. My name is Dan Spatariu. I am a medical doctor, cardiologist, 44 years old, and I practice yoga for 19 years at the courses organized by MISA in Timișoara, a city in western Romania, known as the city where Romanian Revolution started. In the year 2000, together with some fellow yoga practitioner, we founded the NGO Dacica with the purpose of raising the cultural and spiritual level of society by means of yoga and Ayurveda workshops, conferences and festivals. In 2004, during the police attacks on yoga practitioners, I observed with astonishment that Romania society is still full of taboos and preconceived ideas, that it is very receptive to calumnies and tendentious intentions carried vehemently by mass media. I have noticed that from the enormous amount of aspects related to yoga, strangely, mass media systematically choose during all these years to present only and only the aspect of sexuality. Therefore, animated by the intentions to bring transparency and the wish to break the preconceived ideas, we decided to organize an open doors festival and to demonstrate to the public that the sexuality which is taught in Tantra and Tao systems is accessible to modern men. The festival was named Love the Life, and it was very successfully. In seven consecutive years, between 2005 and 2011, we organized seven editions of this festival. This is how events unfolded chronologically. The first edition in 2005 was marked by the withdrawal of funding from the city council. During the meeting of the council, a picture of me at a yoga protest against the abusive and violent actions of police was used as an argument to withdraw funding. Our organization was imposed an embargo also on another project that was planned for later that year, Breath the Life, a project against smoking. We have filed a court case against the city council on the subject of funds withdrawal, but we lost it. In the final judgment of the case, the judge invoked our link to the MISA movement. 2 months after the decision, I received a suggestion to cease my medical activity at the hospital I was working at and whose director was also a member of the city council. In the second edition of the festival in 2006, the guest speakers, famous personalities of Romanian culture, received phone calls alerting them that if they speak at the festival, their names will be associated to MISA. In 2007, Romania accedes to the European Union. In that year, 2 days prior to the festival, for which there were distributed already more than 10,000 flyers, we are informed that the lease contract for the festival hall has been cancelled. Thus, the photo exhibit, what we planned and for which we already invited an artist from France, could no longer take place. The reason invoked, the hall cannot accept exhibit of nudes. We have analyzed the case and found out that the very same library was hosting a photo exhibit of nudes a month ago. Same happened with the hall we rented in the Timișoara Business Center, with which have successfully collaborated for 5 years before that. In the following years, we have been prohibited to promote also events that were not connected to sexuality, the Angels Week, for example. In 2008, because of all the calumnies and lies that constitute a broad media campaign, we decided to reconfigure the relation with the press and to organize a press conference to which we invited all the written and audio video press, more than 40 press units. Not a single journalist came to our press conference. Our rhetoric question to this? Is it a boycott or an indifference that aims to marginalize us? For 2 years, we have successfully carried out sexual education programs in the high schools of Timișoara. The school inspectorate, assaulted by the press in relation to the stigmatization of yoga and Misa, was forced to cancel our program. In 2009, many of the companies who sponsored regularly our events announced that they don't want to appear in the sponsors list. In 2010, Gregorian Bivolaru has been acquitted of the charges in court. In that year, together with the amateur theater group Artemisa, we produced the second series of the movie Zen. Mass media became even more virulent. The movie, which is inspired from allegories and parables of the Oriental tradition, is presented in media as a church movie, insinuating to the public opinion that we carry out blasphemies. On April 2010, we had a meeting with the mayor of Timișoara. I quote, you experience communication issues. You will be understood in 50 years. Too bad I won't be alive then. These words, somewhat realistic, trigger in us a bitter smile for a Romania integrated into the European Union and which obliged to respect Articles 9, 10 and 11 of the Human Rights Convention, freedom of religion and conscience, freedom of expression and freedom of assembly and association respectively. All this being violated in our case. I try to investigate any and analyze if this institutional stigmatization is something that happened specifically in our case and in Misa case, but research showed similar case in other cities and with other organizations. Satya organization from Pitești, Sofrosin Theatre from Bucharest, Romanian Association Unconventional Medicine, also Anima Mundi Foundation of Bucharest. Our conclusion is the next. Stigmatization is born from labeling without communication. When it is systematic and constant during a long time happening in a strong flow, it manifests either ill-willed actions or blatant stupidity. Stigmatization falsifies the reality since it doesn't look beyond appearances. The anachronic mechanism of manipulation by means of mass media are not worthy of a Romania which is a European United Member State. These controls are rather echoes of the medieval or at least of the dictatorial Romania. It carries no vision. It only brings stagnation within the limits of petty interests. It destroys life's perspectives history. As long as it supports such mechanisms, Romania is like a gorgeous woman who walks around with a very bad makeup. Romania needs a mirror. We invite today Europe to be that mirror. Thank you. I have here two books about which shows the reality of Misa movement, also in the times of communism, and also till nowadays, written by Gabriel Andreescu, the founder of the Helsinki Committee of Romania. The synthesis of the book in English is available at the desk. It's interesting to know about it, to read it. And also I have a conclusion, is a rhetoric question. The mass media means pluralism, diversity. Why when this phenomenon of stigmatization happens, all the mass media, almost all mass media is unitary in making something bad. Mm-hmm. How explain? Because the Misa phenomenon was started in the same time. And the more curious than that is that in the same time, it stopped. And just one word can answer to this. The word is comment. was a command. It's like a command, guys. Like I think this is the word.
Right.
Yeah. Thank you.